Number 14 on my top 20 fantasy mod list for medieval Total War Kingdoms. So, Westeros Total War version 1.0. It's the latest release of the Westeros Total War mod, the original mod set in the World of Ice and Fire franchise, and the mod which spawned a million different sub-mods over at Total War Center back in 2011. So Game of Thrones Enhanced, for example, is one of the sub-mods that spawned after this mod was released in an alpha state back then. I believe the 0.54 or 0.53 release of this mod spawned a bunch of sub-mods, including Game of Thrones Enhanced. So of course Game of Thrones Enhanced was a sub-mod that changed the style and the art, etc., into the show style. Well, this mod, the original, was based on the books, and there were a lot of submods that used the style of the original too, and still kept the book style. Okay, we'll go to the campaign, the Westeros campaign. You can see that we only have a few factions, so we don't have that many factions. This mod is only set in Westeros, not in Essos. And it doesn't have any of the Ires outside of Westeros playable either. It has fewer factions than the mod we already previewed, the Song of Ice and Fire Total War mod. So this Westeros Total War 1.0 mod has only Westeros playable, and it doesn't have any areas outside of the wall. I believe the Wildling territory and the wall, etc., they are on the map, but the Wildling faction was never added. I believe the faction might be in the game, but they never added models for the factions. It's a faction without models. So the areas under Wildling control are empty without any garrisons. Okay, so we can play as House Stark, led by Robb Stark. We can play as House Greyjoy, led by Balon Greyjoy. We can play as House Arryn of the Vale, led by, I believe, the same woman, Lyssa Arryn. As in the other mod, it's the same portrait. So the art seems to be the same. We have House Frey of the Twins. The names of the factions are a bit different here, like House Grey of Pike, House Stark of Winterfell, House Arryn of the Vale, and House Frey of the Twins. The portraits are the same as in the other mod, the Song of Ice and Fire mod. We already looked at, and we have House Tully of Riverrun, led by Edmure Tully. We have House Lannister of Castle Rock, and led by Tywin Lannister. We have House Baratheon of King's Landing, led by Joffrey Baratheon, or King Joffrey Baratheon. We have House Baratheon of Dragonstone, led by Stannis Baratheon. And we have House Baratheon of Storm's End, led by Renly Baratheon. And we have House Tyrell, led by Mance Tyrell, and we have House Martell, led by Doran Martell. And this mod, in the past, in the 2011 release, used vanilla models with reskins, and was less impressive in terms of models than the Italian mod. But this version, the 1.0 version, which took over 11 years to, I believe, develop, or at least over 7 years of development. If I'm not wrong, it was 11 years, or it was 7 or something. And this mod actually added a bunch of custom settlements to the mod, like for example King's Landing, the Wall, there were some other areas too that had custom models, Dragonstone, Mount Cailin, and such, and then it had unique models for every faction in the mod, completely custom models that look great, but they are still based on the books and not the show. The problem with this mod, because it also has a bunch of cool scripts and features and custom houses, and see that we can enter the campaign map. The problem with it was that it wasn't very stable. It had some issues with CTD. I have never played it properly, but when I tried it when it released the first time, I believe I had some issues going back and forth in menus. So, for example, if I entered the campaign and clicked on returning to the main menu, then it could crash and such. So it wasn't very stable, but highly impressive in terms of how how it looks on the map. The map is huge. I believe Game of Thrones Fire and Blood is basing their map on this map. I believe P-Man, the creator of Game of Thrones Fire and Blood, used this map, and then he enhanced it and added Essos and such change stuff. But it used to be this map from the beginning. And this mod has a bunch of cool scripts, and I believe Fire and Blood has copied several of the scripts from this mod too. So it's based on this mod pretty much. This mod, unlike Fire and Blood and Game of Thrones Enhanced, is that the difference is that this is book based. It has art from the books, it has models from the books, it has everything based on the books pretty much. And a lot of cool scripts there. Fiefdom scripts and such. This settlement, Mount Caelan, is custom. The wall here, Castle Black, is custom, but it doesn't work in this mod. But I got the files from this mod and made it work in Game of Thrones Enhanced. There's a custom settlement for King's Landing, which is the same as in Game of Thrones Enhanced and Fire and Blood. I believe P-Man has added a bunch of new custom settlements to his mod, but the ones that are shared between Game of Thrones Enhanced, Fire and Blood, and this mod originated from this mod, actually. We have Dragonstone, I believe. We also have Highgarden, but it's just a reskin in battle, it's not a custom city. I believe the custom settlement of Highgarden in Fire and Blood is made by P-Man, or he rigged the model from an official game, so it's not in this mod, and it's not in Game of Thrones Enhanced. Because this mod used just a skin for Highgarden. Winterfell only had a strat model. It didn't have a custom settlement. The one in Fire and Blood is unique to that mod and rigged by P-Man. This mod, however, has some unique features. First of all, you can see that every settlement is shrining. So they have added, like, shrine to every area through a script, so you can see all the areas of your faction and all the settlements of other factions on the map, so you know where they are located, which is very helpful, because the map is huge, so when you march troops, it's annoying, for example, in other mods with similar sizes, for example, Game of Thrones Enhanced, to know where the settlements are, you need to send out spies to find them. But in this mod, they have solved that problem by using scripts, so every settlement is highlighted on the map, and there are a bunch of cool scripted features, events and such. I believe this mod also has a bunch of different family members and minor houses and such. You can check the faction list here. We have a bunch of different characters. We even have Theon in Robb Stark's faction. So he is a part of House Stark here and not House Greyjoy. And we have others. All of them with art from the books. As for the troops, that's not Stark's, that's Frey. So we can see that we have a huge number of characters here. We also have some armies. Look at the troops, we can see that they look very custom. They are not vanilla, but they are not based on the TV show either. Still pretty cool. It's everything that we wanted back in 2011, when we only had vanilla models. But unfortunately, the developers took too long to release this, so the mods with the TV show models arrived before this one. That's why this one didn't get probably the attention it deserved. Because this one used the style of the books, and people prefer the show over the books, but when it comes to the look of stuff. But yeah, they should, in my opinion, have been a little bit faster at releasing the mod. It took 7 years or more to release it. Had they released it earlier, it would have been probably getting way more attention. I mean, Westeros the War was hugely popular back in 2011, 2012, 2013, 2014, back when the show was huge. But in 2016 and such, it wasn't as big. I believe the TV show mods were big still, but this mod released in 2018, I believe, so back then the show had already started to die out, you know. I believe this mod arrived the same year that the final season were aired, so. So they were a little bit slow at releasing it, but I highly recommend it. We will make the campaign map visible. So this mod has those factions that I already previewed. It has a huge map, same as in Fire and Blood, but it's smaller because P-Man has remade the map in his version. So it will include Essos. Of course, this Westeros part has more regions than his, because when he added Essos, he had to remove certain areas from the map. It has really cool, unique models, cool scripts and events and such, and I rank this higher than the Song of Ice and Fire mod because this one has custom stuff, custom settlements, custom models and such, while the other mod used vanilla models, and this map is much more detailed, much more impressive in how it's made, not as flat as the other one, looks more professional. And this mod has a lot of features that took years for the developers to implement. Even though they could probably have released it a little bit earlier. I believe already in 2013 or 2012 they said they had a pretty good version, but then they still didn't release it because they had the in my opinion, stupid opinion that it needs to be perfect before they should release it. My modding philosophy is not to release mods when they are perfect, but instead release beta versions and then improve on them until they reach a perfect state. So in my opinion, they should have released many versions instead of, you know, making a perfect version of the mod. The problem with making it perfect is that it takes forever until they release it, and also that if there is a bug somewhere along the way, that it's much more difficult to fix it because you don't know where it was caused, you know. The problem with the team might be that if I develop a mod alone or with others over a short period of time, like for example, if I develop a mod in 2017 to 2018, then it's easy to know what each of the team members are doing. So it's easy to know where a bug has arrived and where it wasn't present. I believe, for example, if I develop Warcraft Total War in 2017 to 2018 and we are 6 people developing it, and then we know exactly what each person is doing. So it's easy to pinpoint where a bug has arrived and not. We have many different beta versions and it's easy to know where the bug showed up. But if you have a mod being developed, like Westeros Total War, from, I believe, maybe 2009 until 2018, and the release is released, I believe they released an alpha in 2011, then they didn't release another one until 2018, this one. So 2011 to 2018, that's 7 years. So it's 7 years of development. Then many team members will come and go during those 7 years. And the new team members that are working on the mod in 2018 do not know what each and every one of the older team members have done in the mod. So if there is an old issue in the mod can't be solved, or is hard to solve, an issue that causes the game to crash, for example, randomly, then it's almost impossible to pinpoint what the cause is, because the team members in 2018 are not the same as in 2011, 2012 or 2013. So in my opinion, it's not good for a mod's development to have it develop for 7 years without a release. It would be much better to release it at a time when team members start leaving and then leave it to others to continue it from there. But there's no reason to wait until it's perfect. That's my critique of the mod team members behind this mod, that they waited too long before releasing. That's bad both for the issue hunting, but also for the bug hunting, I mean, and also for the mod itself, because interest in Game of Thrones and Westeros died down. I believe it was way bigger back in 2011 to 2014 compared to later. And this mod is still a very good mod, and has, as I said, taken 7 years to develop from 2011 to this to the release of this version. And back in 2011 we still had the alpha, which were the base of a lot of submods. So this is a very well developed mod and should absolutely be played, but I can't promise it's stable. It might be more stable than I think, but also might not be. And that's the problem with developing it for too long, that you don't know where the issue is. That you don't know the cause behind the CTD, if there is any CTD. But the mod is very much custom made. Everything in it is custom, and it's a very, very detailed mod. And in my opinion, it is deserving of place number 14, I think, on my top 20 list of fantasy mods for Medieval Total War Kingdoms. Let's exit to the main menu. There's custom loading screens, of course. Custom battle. Have same factions, no others. Quick battle. Let's check the models in battle. So the loading screens are pretty cool, in my opinion. And as you can see, the models are great. High quality models, professional models. These were the type of models that we dreamt of back in 2011. I remember downloading Westeros Total War Alpha 0.53 or something, or if it was 0.54, and wishing that we had models like this, because they were just reskinned vanilla models like in the Song of Ice and Fire mod, but without all the variations. So it was a much worse mod than the Song of Ice and Fire mod, but it still used vanilla models with reskins. And this mod, which is using custom models here for the House Frey of the Twins faction, is much more impressive. It has custom terrain, custom trees. It's really, really well done, this mod. And its main setback was that it took forever until they actually released it. If it had released in 2014, I'm sure it would have been huge. Back then, the TV show models didn't exist. They arrived in 2016. So if it released any time prior to the TV show models, it would have been received much better. But because the Game of Thrones Enhanced mod had already released, when this released, it didn't receive the attention it was deserving. That's the fault of the modders, because they wanted it to be perfect before they released it, and in my opinion that's the wrong philosophy. Okay, but as we can see, it's very, very beautiful, the mod, and very, very professional, as you can expect if it takes 7 years to develop before they even release it. The models are really good. Horse textures are unique. I have never seen this in another mod. The models might be based on models from other mods, but they look very, very much unique to this one. Even if I recognized one or so models from a different mod, maybe certain gear, but they are unique in how they look, which is very much appreciated. And this mod, as I said, would have been much more popular had it released before 2016. Okay, so this is my top, my place 14 mod on the top 20 list. Westeros Total War 1.0. You should certainly play it if you like Westeros and Game of Thrones. Okay, thanks for watching and we will continue. Number 13. Third Age Total War Reforged. And now I want to make one thing clear. I am a campaign guy. I play Total War for the campaign. I like the single player experience. I never play multiplayer. I played multiplayer once with one guy, and that was this year, a few months back. Never played multiplayer otherwise. Hot Seat I used to play with myself. I used to play every faction in the game. I still play the campaign. So I'm very much a campaign guy, and my top 20 list is for my favorite fantasy mods of medieval Total War Kingdoms. So for example, on my list I want the top 20 best mods in my opinion. And because I play campaigns, I need to rank them based on campaigns. And the Third Age Total War Reforged would be probably the number one mod for medieval Total War Kingdoms if I based it on the multiplayer aspect. If you play multiplayer online battles with others, then this mod is probably number one mod to play. So if you like multiplayer online and playing battles with others, I say this one would be number one. But if you want a single player campaign mod, then this mod is, in my opinion, at place number 13. Because the campaign in this mod is not very polished and is not at all at the level of Divide and Conquer, for example, or even Third Age 4.0 or DCI Lost Alliance. But it's still a cool campaign. Let's check it. So we have a unique UI, by the way, based on Battle for Middle Earth, just like the Rise of Illyria Total War mod. But I believe this mod was first with using it. I believe this mod used it before Rise of Illyria. But it has the same UI as we can see. We have the Third Age campaign, but unlike Divide and Conquer and Third Age 4.0, this campaign is not based on lore. So the Reforged team decided to make a sandbox campaign instead with different factions. So there are some unique factions to this campaign. This campaign do not aim to follow lore and do not aim to follow the books and the movies, and it's more of a sandbox with different factions. I'm not a fan of that setup, but they wanted to have a different campaign compared to Divide and Conquer and other Third Age mods. The rosters, by the way, are the same as in other Third Age mods, but with some unique factions. And I have to praise the models in this mod. I believe Reforged has the best looking Third Age models of any Third Age mod. The models are the best in this mod, and the multiplayer aspect is the best as well. I believe Silmarillion Total War, made by the same guys, have a similarly epic multiplayer experience. But I've never played that mod, so it's not gonna be shown on my list. And it doesn't even have a campaign. This mod had a campaign. If it didn't have a campaign, I wouldn't show it. Because, as I said, my top 20 is for the campaign mods. If you want to play Medieval Total War Kingdoms and you like single player and you like campaigns and you like fantasy, then you should look at my list of top 20 fantasy mods to be played in Medieval Total War Kingdoms in the single player campaign mode. So Reforged, the Reforged campaign mode is at place 13 on my list, but the multiplayer aspect and the modal aspect will be at probably number one when it comes to the multiplayer aspect, and then maybe when it comes to the models, it has the best models of any Third Age mods, in my opinion. This mod has the best models of any Third Age mod. I looked at Divide and Conquer, I looked at Third Age, the original mod, and Third Age 4.0 has the original models. In later versions, they I believe Leo, the creator, has added some new models that are really good looking, but if you compare it with his first release, the only one that I have looked at in depth, and then you compare it with Divide and Conquer, then Divide and Conquer has better models than 4.0. And then this mod has even better models. I would have liked to play Divide and Conquer War 4.0 with the models of Reforged, actually. I even thought about making a submod where I added the models from this mod to the Divide and Conquer campaign or to the 4.0 campaign, because I really disliked the vanilla models of 4.0, because I played the vanilla Third Age Total War from 2009 when it released and until 2012. I can hardly look at them anymore. I get bored. But the models in this mod, they are fresh and really good looking. And then Divide and Conquer has some good models too, but they are just worse than the Reforged models. I can say that much. This campaign is worse than the campaigns in the other mods, in my opinion. It's sandbox, and it doesn't have as many custom cities, and it's very much bare bones compared to the others. We can check the factions though. We have the Realm of Lindon, which is Noldor Elves. We have Artedain, we have Cardolan, we have Dunland, we have Numenor, we have the Redaur, we have the Witch Realm of Angmar, the Orcs of the Misty Mountains, we have the Dwarves of Khazad Dûm, we have Isengard, we have Rohan, we have the Realm of Lothlórien, we have Hobbit Folk as their own faction, which I think is pretty cool. We have the Realm of Mirkwood, we have the Dwarves of Erebor, we have Dale, we have Dorvinion, we have Rune, we have Khand, we have Mordor, we have Gondor, we have Dol Amroth, we have Harad, and we have Umbar. And I checked all the factions in Custom Battle, and I can say that it's really cool with the Hobbit Folk faction. Anyway, we can start the mods campaign. Isengard, my favorite faction in Third Age, Total War, and any submod of it. Isengard was my favorite faction ever since the movies released in the early 2000s. I also read the books, and back in the books I didn't really like any faction, but I liked Gollum. He was my favorite character. Anyway, so this mod has a campaign, but you can see that Isengard doesn't even have the custom strat map model, showing that it's very bare bones compared to other Third Age mods, which is focused on the campaign. So compared to, for example, the original Third Age Total War, this mod doesn't have as many custom settlements in the campaign, but it has a huge number of custom settlements in multiplayer and custom battles, but unfortunately not in the actual campaign. It doesn't have strat models placed out for Minas Tirith, Edoras, and other places. You can see that there are mostly, if not only, vanilla settlements for every area on the map. I don't know if they are custom in battle or not, but on the map they look very vanilla. That's why I never played a campaign in this mod, because I thought it looked unfinished compared to Divide and Conquer and Third Age 4.0, even the original Third Age. May have more factions than the original Third Age, and more factions than in 4.0, but the map itself looked more unfinished, because it has, as I said, mostly vanilla strat models on the map. This settlement is obviously custom, on the map at least. I don't know about in battle, but it's still a huge map, and you can still play as a bunch of different Third Age factions, and it's a cool campaign. And as I said, the models in battle are the best ones of any Third Age mod. They might look like the same here, but they are not. Maybe some of them are the same, but most of the models are HD in this mod, and I believe that they look way better than in the original Third Age mod. We can see that Uruk-hai Archers and Uruk-hai Reavers, see that they are the cards for the archers are new. I believe these guys have new models compared in older versions of Third Age. It crashed, but it's still recording. So the campaign is not stable, it's not very finished, and yeah, I don't think it's good in comparison to other third age mods, but the focus of this mod was multiplayer online battles, so and I rank it based on the campaign. So let's go to custom battles, and we can see that it has a bunch of factions here. If you check Isengard, see that they have a lot of cool units, including a unique Isengard ballista that looks like in the Battle for Middle Earth game, and a unique Fire of Ortenk siege engine. They have a new Troll of the White Hand, similar to the one in Divide and Conquer, but a much better model. They have some new orc models for the Rukai Archers, and Lurt's Hunting Pack is a new unit. We have really good armored Rukai units that I believe have better models than in the original Third Age game. The wargs in this mod are better, they are bigger, and they have better animations when they run, and such. And then, let's see, Gondor, they have a few new models, but let's check Rohan, they were one of my favorites in this mod, and then we can check the Hobbit faction too, because they were really cool. Hobbitfolk. Okay, so conceive it, the faction Hobbitfolk. We have Ents, we have the Great Eagles, but we also have a bunch of Hobbit units. Some of them are based on the old Hobbit unit from Third Age, but then we have some unique ones I haven't seen before. It's a pretty cool little faction with some unique units. And then when we check Rohan, you see that they even have Shield Maidens of Rohan, a female unit with custom female voices and such. The problem with moving it to another mod is that it won't have the female voices, and it's annoying to move over voices to for the unit. But it's a really cool, high quality female unit that I like in this mod that aren't in any other Third Age mod. So I prefer Rohan in this mod in terms of units. They also have civilians, very cool. But they do not have the civilian animation, so that I am using in Hyrule Total War and Warcraft Total War. Maybe they should use that. It makes sense. Yeah, but anyway, the Shield Maidens I really like. And then, of course, the models here are much better than in the original mod. Even if they look similar on the cards, in battle they are much more impressive. Actually, we could start the battle just to take a look at the models. As this mod, after all, is intended for custom battles online, so this mod has way better balance between the factions when you play with other players and against the AI. They balance the factions better. But of course, the campaign sucks compared to other Third Age mods. And that's sad. That's why I would want Divide and Conquer or Third Age 4.0 with these models. I'd like to replace the Rohan of that mod with this Rohan, and the Isengard of those mods with the Isengard in this mod. Pretty much those mods with the rosters from this mod would be awesome. Okay, so the Halflings have a Gandalf's Fireworks siege engine. They have Ents, new Ent model. They have a bunch of different units here, including Eagles that I want to take a look at. So they start dismounted but can fly. They are not huge, but they are still pretty cool. I like that they added creatures. By the way, the Orcs of Mist Mountains in this mod, Third Age Reforged, have drakes too that look exactly like in Battle for Middle Earth. So I really like that they add creatures. One thing I think Divide and Conquer Third Age and Third Age 4.0 and these I Lost Lions lack is creatures. I believe some of the mods had spiders and ends and such, and Sauron himself, even Balrogs. But they were all buggy and would crash a lot or didn't look like in the movies. In this mod they have tried to add creatures that look like in the Battles of Middle-earth games. Of course the eagles, in my opinion, are a little bit too small and too numerous. I think they should be huge, like in Warhammer, like in the movies, and fewer in numbers. But when it comes to the drakes, they looked exactly like in the Battles of Middle-earth 2 games, or game. So I really liked that they added that, but the problem was that they couldn't spit any fire, so they were melee. So maybe they should add the ability for them to actually spit fire. But that's a minor complaint. I like that they have added monsters. One thing I really liked about Herald of War and Warhammer and such is that they have a lot of different creatures and monsters. And Third Age could have more of that, but usually only had humans and elves and dwarves and infantry and cavalry. Based units that didn't have any monsters. So, for example, they didn't have any Nazgûl on fell beasts either, which I wanted. Unlike the Lord of the Rings mod for Rome to the War that had fell beasts and such that were flying. So that's something I preferred in the Rome to the War mod, that I were disappointed in this mod, that they were all just riding horses. But let's start the game, start the battle, I mean. We won't play it, but we should take a look at Rohan. We can see that the Rohan faction also has a bunch of cool models. Rohan, of course, looks like a Norseman faction, Viking style. They are mounted for the most part, but their dismounted units look like Vikings, pretty much. Shield Maidens of Rohan here. Really good looking female unit. This is one unit that I would probably port over to any Third Age mod that I would play Rohan. If I play Rohan in any mod set in Third Age, I would probably move over this model, even if I can't move over the voices for the unit. So it would still speak like a man, but I believe I've added voices to a one mod once, but then I had a guide for it and I could follow it, but now I don't remember every file I need to change and such. So it's easier to just move over the model without moving over the voice. But this model has actual female voice lines and such. It's very well done by the Reforged team. And this Rohan faction is the best by far. Look at these detailed models. Medusaid, guard, etc. All of them look so fucking good. They have really high quality touch to them that I don't think that the original Third Age has. The original Third Age used very, very outdated models by today's standards. I mean, they were good back in 2009 and probably still good back in 2012. But today, if you compare them with these models, it's no comparison at all. And if you look at Divide and Conquer, they have, I believe Divide and Conquer is using some of the models from this mod, and they have some good models that they have made themselves, but still, there is no competition. This mod has the best models out of all of the Third Age mods, and the only complaint is that it has the worst campaign. I would like these models in the best campaign, so obviously someone where someone takes these models and plays in Divide and Conquer would be great. But yeah, this mod has the best models and the best multiplayer, but the worst campaign out of the Third Age mods, and its campaign is at place 13 in my book, because it's Third Age, so it needed to be high. But it couldn't be placed higher than place 13, because it's very unfinished and bare bones in the campaign. It has all the factions placed out, but probably no custom settlement. And the map looked very, very bare bones compared to the other Third Age mods. But I still recommend this mod for multiplayer and custom battles, and you should still probably try out the campaign just because it has glorious models in battle. Okay, so this is number 13 on my top 20 list for Medieval Total War Kingdoms in the fantasy mods genre. So let's continue.